exist. What I'm saying is the approach the state has taken, the statist, government-centric, politician-heavy laden approach that we've taken, is absolutely useless to beating this virus and really giving ordinary people the ability to exit this current madness that we're in. And Adam, let me come to you to this particular point, because I would argue, therefore, that there is an incentive by the political elites to not want to adopt a rational approach, and that actually the current status quo of them controlling everything in this particular and dealing, excuse me, with COVID-19, they have the incentive. And that's let's look at a one Zweli Mkhize as a prime example of this. The revelation that then popped out, shout out to is it Daily Maverick that did the investigative work of this? Shout out to them on this. I might have my gripes with you guys on some other issues, but I can't fault you when it comes to the investigative journalism. To then point out that, you know, the health minister has actually been dishing out cash allegedly to his friends via this current he's actually been doling out the cash via the piloting of what will be the NHI, the National Health Insurance, and when the COVID-19 situation came on, physically doled out millions to friends who then set up a communications company in order to communicate on this disease and to basically make the minister look good effectively. Talk to me, because there's a conversation to be had here about, number one, when you give politicians almost exclusive power to decide winners and losers in society, the winners inevitably will be people who are friends of those politicians, number one. And number two, the reason for picking them isn't even to assist people, right? In this case, provide healthcare. The reasons are just, here's a mate of mine, he needs a few millions. Some of those will come back to me to allow me to run for this election again. And that becomes the whole nexus, if you will, and the reason for why we see the political elites wanting the state to control something like the COVID response.
Absolutely, Sihle. And maybe just a quick comment there, seeing as Gabriel said that the ANC actually helped the virus spread. I think the solution to stopping the virus in its tracks is quite clear. We just need to give the ANC a mandate to spread the virus. Then yes, it will completely disappear and we'll never see another infection again. I think that's exactly what needs to be done. Unfortunately, that's not what's going to happen. No, Sihle, in regards to the revelations now with Dr. Zweli Mkhize, I think this just shows again that the ANC is rotten to the core. What you see here is just a vast, vast patronage network. Corruption up and has seeped into the very foundations of this party and the government structures that are at their disposal. So in regards to Zweli, my favorite thing that the good doctor told us was, I didn't personally benefit from any of this, but he fails to mention that it's his family and friends. But I mean, maybe he just neglected to mention that. But I think there's a myth that needs to be dispelled here. And the myth that needs to be dispelled is the fact that there's a good and a bad faction within the ANC. There's a corrupt faction, and then there's a faction that's fighting the good fight. And Cyril is at the lead and he's at the helm, but he's being held back by some imaginary forces or whatever. No, it's pretty much just a good cop, bad cop routine, but both cops work for the same corrupt police station. That's what we're seeing with the ANC. And whether it's ACE's RET faction or Cyril's New Dawn faction...
Cyril is also RET. What is more RET than expropriation without compensation? And that's his signature policy.
Yeah, we've seen, and it's not just expropriation that we've seen come to the fore under Cyril Ramaphosa. We've also seen, I think we're, and I don't have the statistics on hand, but I'd like to, I'd like for someone that's good in statistics to dig into that. I think we are well on our way to have more hours of load shedding under the New Dawn government than we did under the Zuma government. But I'd like to see at the end of Cyril Ramaphosa's reign what's going to happen there. So maybe just to sum that up in regards to this factionalism, I think if you're going around talking about if just the good faction within the ANC wins, there will be reform and then everything will be fine, you're pretty much just saying that, yeah, there's two crocodiles that want to eat me, but at least one of them brushes their teeth, so we need to hope that he wins. No, you shouldn't be rooting for a crocodile. You shouldn't be rooting for an evil faction. You shouldn't be voting for evil. Don't just say, I'm rooting for the lesser of two evils. Refuse to root for evil. I think that's a very reasonable stance to take. So in regards to the ANC and how rotten it's become, I think when you have a party that's looted funds from the sick and the vulnerable during a pandemic, if you are still making excuses for this party, you are venturing into territory where that is an immoral act and it should be treated accordingly.
And a lot of people fighting back against this nonsense, conscious Caracol, whoever he or she is one of them.